President Obama is expected to talk mainly jobs and the economy on Tuesday. He may have also specially selected the birthday of President Lincoln for the date of his address. Margaret Hoover, CNN political contributor and Republican consultant working on behalf of individuals on policy issues, and CNN contributor and senior political columnist for Newsweek and The Daily Beast, John Avlon, join me now from New York. Thank you both for being here. Let me start.
Absolutely. Thanks for having us.
You're welcome. Let's talk about the president. What do you think he will say that will be different, say, from addresses in the past? And Margaret, ladies first.
Oh, kind of you. Appreciate it. Look, I hope that he takes a page out of Lincoln's book. If he truly picked Lincoln's birthday for this moment, this is a great opportunity to realize that against the backdrop of his inaugural address, if he really wants a legacy legislative reform, the reality is that there's a divided government. And he has an opportunity to not polarize the debate, but really reach out and broaden the debate and include Republicans. There are great, really hopeful steps taken forward in the last few weeks with immigration reform. I hope he keeps going in that direction rather than polarizing or poisoning the well, continues to build on the growing support for immigration reform.
And John, never too early to start burnishing that legacy. Is that it?
Well, that is it. And this is a time of maximum political influence for President Obama, this sweet spot in administrations right after a re-election. So the challenge is going to be to really apply some policy prescriptions that are ambitious but achievable. And that with the reality divided government, that means reaching out. Polls all show the top issues in the country, the economy and jobs, and then the deficit. And the issue, I think, for Democrats is not to overreach, not to feel that they can ignore the issue of deficit. They're going to have to find a way, and the president's going to have to put some real plans on the table behind the rhetoric of reducing the debt, in addition to investment and immigration reform, which are all consistent with making America more competitive in the 21st century.
What about gun violence? This was an issue, of course, that was an extremely hot topic just only a few weeks ago. Now that seems to really be fading away. Do you expect the president to make a major issue of that in his speech? John?
Well, you know, I think the president will address gun violence. He barely noted it in his inaugural address. This is a time for policy prescriptions and following through. Newtown has created an urgency behind this issue that the president really does have an obligation to follow through on. And so I do expect that immigration and guns will be core aspects of this speech, but all underneath the larger framework about making the economy work for the middle class. And that will be, I believe, the frame of this State of the Union.
Margaret, do you think the fact that he hasn't been talking so much about guns is the fact that there was so much pushback?
You know, I actually think what's happened behind the scenes since the president mentioned it, John's right, only barely in the inaugural address, is there actually behind the scenes have been a group of senators, Republicans and Democrats, Republicans like Tom Coburn from Oklahoma, Democrats who are supporters of comprehensive background checks. How do you make it work? What are policies that are actually going to make a difference in a quiet working group in the Senate trying to figure out what can get passed? So I expect the president will say something tomorrow, probably to stoke the flames and get it back in the public conscience. And my sense is that there actually is hope to potentially get something done on gun control. Probably not something as expansive as Dianne Feinstein's bill, but maybe universal background checks could move forward.
Let me, real quick, we've only got about 30 seconds for both of you to respond. Sure. An olive branch to Congress, do you expect that? John, do you think the president's going to be waving that, or is it not a kumbaya moment?
I think that it is an obligation to do that, and Republicans have to respond in kind, not just rhetoric of bipartisanship, but actually reaching out and backing policies that they've backed in the past but have tried to obstruct under President Obama.
And Margaret?
Maybe if it's Lincoln's birthday, he did it for a reason. He'll take a page out of the playbook. We've all been seeing the movie Lincoln. We know it's up for Academy Awards. He'll hopefully take a page out of how that 13th Amendment got passed.
Yeah, correct.
And bring us all together.
We could all be deeply inspired by that. Yeah,
that's right.
Very, very appropriate. Thank you both very much for joining us to talk
about
State of the Union.
Thanks.